السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. One of the clear concepts in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that we are held responsible for our actions, whether it's good or bad, to be accountable for our actions. And it doesn't matter whether it's a major action or a small action, we are held accountable for our actions. One of the very easy ones to remember, something that is a surah that many of us have it memorized. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. Whoever do the weight of an atom of goodness, he will see it in the hereafter. And whoever do the weight of an atom of evil, he will see it in the hereafter. See how precise and how small that is. And that's why some of the early generations of Islam, they said that you might think that nobody will be saved when you read these verses. Because the size of the deed, even if it's an atom's weight of evil, you will see it in the hereafter. This is such a severe matter. This is something that we need to pay attention to. Of course, with the rest of the verses of the Quran, there is repentance, there is tawbah, and the tawbah wipes all the sins, even if it's a major one. So there's the repentance, there's the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is the pardoning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Day of Judgment. There's all kinds of things that wipes away the sins and the dua of others and so on. But to be accountable for our actions, this is our duty, this is what we need to be upon in the face of earth. If a person steals billions or steals a dollar, does it really matter or there's any difference between both when it comes to the sin itself, the seed of that in the heart? That person that allowed himself to steal something very small, very insignificant, that means he has that seed in his heart. He has that sinful attitude in his heart. But whatever was made easy for him is that small amount of money that he stole. If it was something major, right, he would have definitely took the means to take it away. The same thing with all kinds of sins. Many times we're not tested. And that's why we need to test our hearts. Not to test ourselves physically, to take ourselves into harm's way or to fitan, we're ordered to stay away because we are weak. As human beings, we are weak. We need to stay away from what is evil. But we need to test our hearts to bring the piety and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to remember these types of verses that we are accountable for our actions. A word of mouth can take the person to the highest levels, as the Prophet said, or take the person into the worst levels of the hellfire. One word. We know that a person might be among the disbelievers with a word of mouth. That means we have to be watchful of what we say. Ghiba or backbiting is a word of mouth. Not even a word of mouth. A person might make something with his face, a gesture with his face, that shows that he belittling someone. That's a major sin. You know, blinking one's eye. Making a hand gesture like this. It shows that when a person's name is mentioned, so and so is mentioned, then a person would do something like this. That's a major sin. So that means we are held accountable for every action that we do, whether it's speech or actions, every step we take, we need to be conscious. We need to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us and He's the all-hearer subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our attitude. Many times when people read about the mercy of Allah and the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if they are saying to themselves, we can do whatever we want because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. He is the most forgiver, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He treats us with His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we're talking about our attitude, our actions, our being. And the like of this one, the Prophet ﷺ said, سَدِّدُوا وَقَرِبُوا سَدِّدُوا, that means be perfect. The Qur'an says, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ, fear Allah, be dutiful to Allah to the best of your ability. This is our attitude. And this is how we have good expectations of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we do the best we can, and then we think about the mercy of Allah and the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make ourselves accountable for all of our actions, as we heard in the verses of the Quran. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and to shield us from the hellfire and to make us among the people of Jannah. Wa sallallahu sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.